Hello, my name is Pinar. I'm from Bartlett School of Architecture, and my supervisors are Marie Fraser, one of our chairs, Sophia Pissara, and John Bolt from University of Westminster. My research title is Musealisation in the Urban Context, Multiple Narratives of Sultanahmet Archaeological Park in Istanbul's Peninsula. Substantial structural changes in global economies and market influences on cultural tourism have resulted with the expansion of museums from the boundaries of buildings to historic urban areas, initiating extensive regeneration. As you can see some examples. Consequently, museum quarters are established by renovating historic museums, as in the case of Berlin Museum itself, converting historic city centers into museums, quarters as in Vienna, or from scratch as in the case of Amsterdam. Musealization of urban areas is generally associated with a motif serving heritage industry. Thus, the process has been widely criticized by scholars and named as museumification, meaning turning a once vivid and living heritage into a staged artifact. At present, almost every aspect of culture is presented in museums, and most of the historic buildings and urban areas are transformed into museums. In Baudrillard's words, the museum, instead of being circumscribed as a geometric site, is everywhere now like a dimension of life. As it mentioned by Kuzel, the whole environment can be regarded as one large museum if we recognize it as such and if we apply musealization. Therefore, musealization can be implemented to all natural and man-made things, as well as to preservation in situ. In this context, the thesis aims to analyze how musealization expands from the boundaries of buildings to urban areas and assess its impacts through the case of Sultanahmet in Istanbul's historic peninsula. You can see the view of the peninsula, Sultanahmet region. Considering Turkey as a context, Sultanahmet has been the major witness of musealization activities, starting with the rearrangement of Hagia Irene as the first public museum of the Ottoman Empire and the construction of new imperial museum. Besides, musealization attempts in urban scale can also be traced in the regularizations of urban form in the 19th century, such as the demolition of the surroundings of important monuments or creation of urban parks. Here you can see Hagia Sophia and Hippodrome in Istanbul. In the early years of the Republic, Topkapı Palace, which was considered as an icon of the Ottoman Empire, was converted into a museum. According to the authorities, restoration approach was recovering the palace of Mehmet the Conqueror and saving it from additions stuck on during the period of decline. Similarly, former Byzantine Church of Hagia Sophia, which was converted into a mosque after Istanbul conquest by the Ottomans, was transformed into a monument museum due to its religious and symbolic connotations. In his master plan for Istanbul, Henry Prost projected Sultanahmet as an archaeological park by presenting important Byzantine monuments after excavations. The plan is evaluated by Akpınar as secularization of the old Ottoman capital by valuing former Constantinople. In 1960s, the mosaics of Constantine's Great Palace were opened as an on-site museum. In addition, Palace of İbrahim Paşa was arranged as Turkish and Islamic Arts Museum, again by highlighting its 16th century architectural features. From the 1980s onwards, tourism-oriented decisions began to shape the area. Hagia Sophia and its surroundings were declared as a tourism area. In 1985, with three other historic areas of Istanbul, Sultanahmet Archaeological Park was internationally recognized and listed as World Heritage Site. In 2009, a management plan was prepared for the peninsula, which is required by UNESCO for World Heritage Sites. The vision was to transform Sultanahmet into a museum's quarter, raising concerns on built heritage, social structure, and everyday life. Today, Sultanahmet Square and its vicinity, including Hippodrome, Great Palace Mosaics Museum, Topkapı Palace, Hagia Sophia, and Turkish and Islamic Arts Museum, function as the museum's quarter of Istanbul. Here you can see the current situation of the area. Service functions of the museum's quarter inevitably split to surrounding buildings. Most of the Ottoman houses in the neighborhood are utilized for touristic facilities, such as hotels, souvenir shops, or restaurants. Musealization of Sultanahmet sometimes carries things too far and produces its own fake objects. By constructing authentic like new buildings, a superficial setting of the Ottoman past is created for the neighborhood. The increased popularity of Istanbul as a tourist destination creates pressure of new constructions. The hotel on the ruins of Great Palace and new buildings attached to the sea walls of Constantinople raise further concerns, especially for Byzantine heritage. You can see some examples again. Although Sultanahmet is a major tourist destination, the area is inseparable from everyday life. Musealization is a continuous mechanism, constantly enlarging its sphere of influence in the urban context. Therefore, its impacts should be evaluated comprehensively in order to propose alternative visions for the future of the area. Thank you.